Hi, this is Sandy. Today we'll be exploring two great things that work great together, Pic Collage and Thinglink. These are web tools that can be used to create your living vision board. The idea behind a vision board is to help your students set tangible goals, both short-term and long. I will also share with you two great websites where you can download free high-quality images for your vision board. Before we get started, don't forget to subscribe and hit that bell to enable notifications for our channel by clicking our logo during the video. Also, leave us a comment or check out our related videos by clicking the pop-up cards in the upper right corner. Ready to set some goals? Let's begin. First of all, I would like to briefly explain vision boards. Sometimes they're called dream boards, and they are a collage of visual goals that serve as your image of the future. Everybody has their own idea of what they want their future to look like, so these boards help us stay on track to make it happen. Sort of like mind mapping. Everybody is inspired by something different, and that's what makes vision boards so unique. They are personal to you and display everything that you desire for your future. What is a living vision board? Well, you'll create your vision board and it'll serve as a dynamic vision that is continually edited and updated. Living documents are changed through revisions that may or may not reference previous changes. The first app we'll use is Pic Collage. In Pic Collage, you get to choose your starting point. You can keep it organized with a grid or go into it freestyle. You can also go up here to this plus sign. Once you click the plus sign, it'll ask you to tap anywhere to add a photo. You can collect photos from your computer. You can actually take photos, use a web search. You can actually draw on this. You could add really cool text. They have some interesting stickers, and you could change up the background. Now, it's always good to use your own pictures for this project, but there are two websites that are really great and they're free. You can get some beautiful images. All you do is search the image out, and once you search the image, you hit enter, and all of these images come up. So you could download these images. This is called Pixabay, P-I-X-A-B-A-Y, and another one is called Pexels. And Pexels is the same exact setup. You search for the photo, they pop up, and here they are. So if you have pictures of things you want to use for your dream board, like a brand new car that you don't have yet or whatever, you could always look it up here. So that's always a great option. Now, once you create your collage, you go ahead and click this little button down here at the bottom right. And once you click that, it'll actually give you some options. You could print it, you could set as a lock screen, or you could save it. We want to save it. And it'll ask you where to save it. You can name it, and you hit save. Now you have your collage saved in your computer somewhere. You're going to open up Thinglink. Now, when you go to Thinglink, you'll go to the front page and you'll hit the Create button. The Create button will bring you to Upload Image, Upload Video, and you're going to upload the image. You're going to find the image that you created, and there you have it. Once you have uploaded your digital collage in Thinglink, this is where you could add the interactions. These buttons are interactive buttons that take me to YouTube videos, but you can also add like web pages or whatever you want. You're going to click on the Add Tag button, and then you can actually add a text label, text and media. What I'm going to do is I'm going to add content from a website. I've already copied a video of cute puppies from YouTube, and I'm going to paste that URL right here. The cool thing is you could change the icon. So if you want to change the icon, it'll ask you color choices, and then you hit done. Here it is. And when I click on it, it'll actually take me to that web page. When you click the done button, it'll bring you to this page. You'll click the share button. It will not let you download offline unless you have a membership, but to share the link, publish to social, and to embed your media is all free.
Thanks so much for watching. Be sure to like, comment, or reply to one of our other videos, or share the playlist below. Subscribe to our channel and enable notifications so that you don't miss out on the next episode. Don't forget to check out our other resources like this cast, podcast, and see what else is going on in Horry County Schools. Be sure to follow @DearDisses on social media or contact us via email or our blog.